What would happen to your liver if you ate canola oil every single day? A brand new study just came out asking exactly this question. And they compared canola oil to ghee, which is a form of clarified butter that's really popular in places like India. This comparison is very interesting because they're two very different fats. Ghee is very high in saturated fat. Canola is low in saturated fat and high in unsaturated fats, especially monounsaturated fat and to some extent polyunsaturated fat. Also, ghee is often used to cook. Regular butter has a low smoke point, so it burns at fairly low temperature, so it's not a great choice to cook. But ghee has a much higher smoke point, so it's often used in cooking. So it's likely that people replacing all the ghee in their diet with canola oil are going to use these respective fats to cook. Which gets at an interesting question that people often ask, which is the effect of heating different types of fat, saturated or unsaturated fats respectively, on health. So the study recruited 110 participants who regularly consumed ghee in their life, roughly 100 to 400 calories a day, ballpark, and little to no canola. It split the participants randomly. Half continued on their normal diet. The other half swapped all the ghee in their diet with the same amount of canola oil. The researchers were especially interested in liver health, so they chose participants with fatty liver diagnosed to see what effect these two different fats would have. The participants kept food diaries on different days of the trial, which confirmed that the control group kept eating their ghee as normal, while the canola group stopped eating ghee and upped their canola intake instead. After 3 months of the trial, the folks on the canola group had a substantial improvement in their fatty liver. The percentage of participants seeing a reduction of their fatty liver grade was 25% in the ghee group and 84% on canola. This matches the findings of another randomized trial we looked at previously, where both olive oil and canola oil improved fatty liver. Liver enzymes also improved more in the folks on the canola group. They also had lower total cholesterol and LDL cholesterol on canola, which is expected because it's much lower in saturated fat. And this helps confirm that in fact the groups are complying with their respective fats. The folks on canola also had lower triglycerides, fasting glucose, fasting insulin, and insulin resistance. Now, if I see a reduction in liver fat, triglycerides, glucose, the first thing I think is weight loss. It's the most consistent trigger of an improvement in these metrics. And in fact, they lost weight, about 4 kilos lost in the canola group, and no weight loss on the ghee group. And other metrics of body weight or body composition, like BMI, waist-to-hip ratio, waist circumference, were all reduced on canola. Now, there is something a little strange. The researchers estimated total caloric intake in both groups, and they didn't find a significant difference. So either the folks on canola are losing weight without cutting calories, or they miscounted their calories and they are in fact eating fewer. My guess would be the latter. Either way, this is interesting because there's a common idea online that seed oils make people fat. And I think this is because people associate seed oils with these junky packaged ultra-processed foods like cookies or chips. And there is a nugget of truth there because many of these foods add seed oils together with all the other ingredients. But I think it's pretty straightforward to see that seed oils are not the problem. One of the most egregious junk foods when it comes to weight gain and health in general is soda, which has no seed oils. Plus, when we look at studies that give the actual oils to people to use with their meals, not in the context of these packaged, ultra-processed, junky foods, we don't see these negative effects. If anything, we tend to see benefits. In fact, we've looked before at a large meta-analysis of 25 randomized trials where they found that canola oil, if anything, led to a slight weight loss. So we have a lot of evidence that junk food is bad in spite of the fact that it includes seed oils, probably because it's very tasty and hypercaloric and leads to caloric overconsumption. But if instead of seed oil, it contained a different type of fat, like ghee, for example, the evidence is telling us the junk food would actually be worse. Okay, so the participants on the canola group lost weight. Does the weight loss explain all the observations with the different metrics that we looked at? The authors carried out an adjustment of their results for the weight loss, and the numbers for most of the liver enzymes became non-significant. So that suggests that indeed these improvements in liver enzymes might be explained by the weight loss. Although all of the other metrics, the cholesterol, the triglycerides, the fasting glucose, etc., remain significant. So there may be something else going on besides the weight loss. Now let's talk limitations. The study has a few. One is duration. 3 months is interesting but doesn't tell us what happens after 3 years or 30 years. Another limitation is what we might call the new diet effect. In this trial, half the participants continued on their normal diet, the other half changed their diet and started eating canola oil. And when we change our diet, we start paying more attention to what we eat, and that in itself can have some effects. It's also possible that by eating different fats, the participants might have changed other foods that they eat with those fats. Although the researchers did think of this, and intake of dairy, cereals, sugar, fruit, total fat, other oils, vegetables, and meat were not significantly different between the two groups, at least as reported by the participants, although, as we saw, the calories reported are a little sus, so grain of salt. And they also estimated physical activity, and it wasn't significantly different between the two groups. Now, here's a question people often ask. Is it possible that a food can perform differently if the background diet is different? Always a theoretical possibility. With any food or any risk factor, maybe canola oil would perform worse in a low-fat diet or a vegan diet or a low-carb diet, or maybe it would perform even better. Both possible with any food. If you're not a regular viewer, the results shared in this video might surprise you. You might have even already typed an angry comment. But the reality is, this mirrors a lot of the existing evidence on canola oil. In fact, we've looked at this systematically in a previous video, all the published evidence for canola oil on heart health, glucose metabolism, cancer, mortality, inflammation, oxidation, a lot of other topics. After going through all those data, not only is the effect consistent, but it's pretty impressive. I've actually decided to add some canola oil to my diet. Just mix it up. Sometimes I use olive oil, sometimes I use canola oil. Doesn't mean it's the right strategy for everyone. You don't need any canola oil or any oil of any kind in your diet, personal preference, but based on the data that I've seen, makes sense to me. That video where we go over all the human evidence on health effects of canola oil, you will have a hard time finding people on social media sharing this type of information. I'll link that right here. And here's one on seed oils and inflammation. Another common question with surprising answers. Check those out. I'll see you over there. Take care.